While appearing before the Budget Committee to defend the budgetary allocations and ministerial policy statements for the Minister of Foreign Affairs, the chairperson of the Parliament's Committee of Foreign Affairs, Nora Bigira, noted that although funds for missions abroad are budgeted in Uganda shillings, they are transferred in foreign currency, which results into loss in currency value due to fluctuation of foreign exchange rates.
It's not about us giving monies in foreign currencies. But when it comes to accountability, these people get losses on foreign service allowances. Because if we send money, and they're supposed to grow, like in three times, then their money is reduced. They cannot be able to get the allowance that is due to them. That's one of the challenges. So something has got to be done, maybe from here, and maybe put the additional for them.
However, committee members protested the proposal on ground that it's not acceptable in laws of Uganda to make a budget in a currency other than Uganda shillings.
Foreign currency?
Yes,
the law doesn't allow. So we shall have to continue budgeting there. But budgeting in, and we can't even budget speculatively that the dollar will appreciate against the shillings. So we mitigate that by budgeting for more resources.
There is no prohibition in the Uganda shilling having a similar weight with any other currency in the world. Other countries don't have that problem because they able to plan for the economy. We are having that. We may have that challenge because partly we have poor economic planning.
The Committee of Foreign Affairs is also concerned with unfavorable host country labor laws, where they set minimum wage so high compared to Uganda's standards, thus making it difficult for some Uganda's embassies to hire domestic staff.
Switzerland, for example, the minimum wage is the equivalent of $3,800. And her lamentation is this is higher than what our home-based staff earn.
You cannot say you're backward, but you have to abide. So to employ somebody there, it necessitates you to pay them accordingly. So members, I pray that we follow that diplomacy.
The deplorable staff of Uganda's mission abroad, with some having their properties condemned by the host countries, has also concerned Parliament. For instance, the permanent mission in Ottawa, Canada, which was condemned by authorities in Canada, thus affecting Uganda's image abroad.
Diplomacy starts with the image, and the foreign missions abroad, many of them are really in a very deplorable state, some of which are condemned by the host countries. For example, foreign mission in Ottawa, Canada, that's
24. Some of the embassies, the cost of rent is in billions. It is expensive than buying a building. For example, an embassy paying over 2 billion, 3 billion a year. And buildings can be bought on mortgage or on mortgage. And where payment comes monthly or yearly, the same way we are paying rent. So the best option would be to rent for purchase.
Meanwhile, the Budget Committee has halted approval of 50 billion shillings requested by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs to host the Non-Aligned Movement Summit and G77 Conference.
We fail as members of Parliament most times when we see requests like that. Organize a 2 days conference, you spend 30 billion. It defeats everyone's understanding.
I remember I wasn't here by that time. Maybe some of you who are more senior than me, we did host Chogam here. Eh? Whether it was the loss of what, but there were so many advantages that came by us hosting Chogam. Quite a number. Hotel industry, a number of them. So I also want to believe that for us being the chairperson of NAM for the 3 years, we shall be able to benefit a lot.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.